Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, I want to show you how you can combine data from multiple cells into one. So this data could be in the form of text, it could be in the form of numbers, but you can still put it together in one cell. Once you have this formula in place, you can copy it right down. Let's get started on these step-by-step instructions. Using any functions like concat or text join here today, we're going to do a different approach. And the other thing I just want to point out is I'm keeping this quite simple with two columns, but you can add more columns and then just continue on with a pattern that I'm showing you. So how we do this is we're going to start with our equation sign here, so our equal sign, and we're going to just select the first cell, and then we're going to use the ampersand sign, which is above the 7, shift 7. And now we click on our next cell, and I'm just going to hit enter. So as you can see, it's not quite exactly what I showed you in the intro. We need to do a few more things to it. So the first thing that we could do is give a space in between the R and the 3 here. So we can do this by going back up to the formula bar up here. So I'm just going to go ahead and select here, and I'm going to type in just the quotation marks here. And I'm going to put a space. So I just hit spacebar, put another quotation mark, and now I need to add another ampersand sign, and I'm going to hit enter. So by doing that, now if I click on it, this space between the quotation marks acts as the space here. So what I'll, if I wanted a dollar sign on this too, where it says the 350,000, I could go up here and I'm going to place it right here. So I have a space, but then I'm going to do my dollar sign, hit enter, and now I have a dollar sign right there. I'm going to come back and show you how we can format this number in a bit here, but I'm just going to continue on to show you that we can add an ampersand sign at the end too. So if I wanted to add that per episode, I just can go up to the top here, and this is where I can add another ampersand sign. And use, when you're typing, you need to use your quotation mark. So I'm going to say per episode, but I want a space. So I'm going to add a space first, and I'm going to say per episode, just like this. And I'm going to go quotation mark, and I'm going to hit enter. So now I have Winona Ryder $350,000 per episode just by using the ampersand sign and using the quotation marks to put spaces. Now there's something else I want to do. I could copy this all the way down just by double clicking and filling in, but I'm going to go back one step because I want to add formatting now. So this is a cool part of this because I want to add a formatting to this 350,000 where I have the comma in the correct spot and I'm going to have the dollar sign. So I'm going to actually remove the dollar sign from here because I'm going to use formatting for this. And what I'm going to have is we are going to use a function too. But before I go grab, put the function in, I'm going to grab some formatting. And to do this, you can right click anywhere in here. So I'm just going to right click and I'm going to go to format cells. You can see it right here. And I'll drag this up and where you need to go to custom. You can see all the things in here. We're going to actually copy formatting out of here. And so in the case of the number here that I want in it, it's going to be, it's going to have a dollar sign. I want it to be formatted and I want it to have comma. So if I look at this here, this is, you can see there's going to be negative, positive, how it's going to be formatting. I could take the whole thing and move it over. Or I could just take a chunk. So what I'm going to do is just highlight what I need here. And I'm going to just go Control C for copy. So I'm going to have this. I'm going to hit OK now. And a shortcut for this, if I go back to it, if I just hit Control 1, that's the shortcut that will get you there in a hurry too. So two ways to do that. Now, if I go back to this cell, I need to add the text function. And where I'm going to add it is before the B2. So B2 is the number. And I'm just going to start by typing text. And you can see the functions come up. And I'm going to just select text. It adds the bracket for me. And on this side of the B2, I need to add a comma. If you follow along, you can see where it says comma next. And I need to add a quotation mark. So I'm going to be pasting in that information that I copied from the formatting. So I'm going to go Control V. And now I'm going to go and do another quotation mark to end it. And I need to close my bracket. So when I close my bracket, I'm just going to go ahead and hit enter. And you can see now this is formatted with a comma to separate the thousands, and it has the dollar sign in there. So at this point, I can copy this all the way down, and it copies all the way down correctly with the formatting in here also. I hope this tip about how to combine data from multiple cells in Excel has helped you out and you can start using it right away. I just want to point you towards a different video of mine about how I show you to format cells that you can put text in it and still have a working formula with it. So I'll put the link right here. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.